Hello, everybody. Andrea Majewski here with Dentalelle. So if you have submitted either your quality assurance test or if you've submitted your portfolio, the CDHO has actually been calling a lot of people from what I am told for their practice profile. So that is what I'll be talking to you guys a little bit about. So the purpose of this video is to talk about, so why would the CDHO be calling? Because if you've never had a call from the CDHO before, you're probably thinking, oh my goodness, did I do something wrong? Did I not pass? Why are they calling me? I can honestly say, you guys, don't worry. Okay. Yes, it's always nerve-wracking to get a call from them, but they're just calling to ask questions. They're not calling to ask questions because you've done something wrong necessarily. It could just be something on your practice profile. They didn't understand what you meant, so they might ask you more about it. So here are a couple of examples. So they might be calling you saying, so you didn't mention about your mask and if you change it after every patient or not. You might have put down in your practice profile you usually change it, or you know, something along those lines. So they would just simply ask you, so do you change your mask after every patient, yes or no? Or a common question seems to be, what did somebody tell me, do you use your utility gloves in the sterilization area? Because they don't ask you that on the practice profile in a way. So unless you did mention that, they will probably ask you what you wear when you're processing the instruments. So it's literally easy questions like that. You just have to be honest. They might say something to you like, oh, you had said in your practice profile that you have a statum and a tetanour sterilizer. What do you do differently between the two to process the instruments? Do you wrap them in a wrap? Do you use a pouch to put them in? Do you use internal indicators? Even if you did say all of that on your practice profile, they might just be calling to make sure that you're actually doing that. Okay, so yes, it's still nerve-wracking. You're probably thinking, oh my goodness, I'm getting a call from the CDHO. The best thing to do is to just talk to them sooner rather than later. It will probably take like 5 minutes and then you'll be all done, you guys. You don't have to worry, which is nice. A lot of you guys might be wondering, well, have I ever gotten a call from the CDHO before? Yes. And they just had a couple questions. And I literally answered them in about 5 minutes, maybe even 6 minutes. They were so nice. You know, the person who I did speak to, she was so, so nice. It was easy. She pretty much said, okay, well, thank you for taking the time. We'll get back to you if we need anything else. And then they will send you a letter after that with either, you know, everything looks good, you don't have to worry, you have passed, or they might ask you to call them back even. I've heard of a letter asking them to, or asking you to call them back to just sort of talk about a couple extra things. If they didn't love what you told them, they might either give you a site, they might give you a site visit, or they might just simply say, well, you need to take this course because you don't understand the sterilization processing, you know, something like that. So it's not as bad as you might be thinking. Okay. So I hope this helped. If you guys have any questions, let me know. If you have any comments, let me know. Has the CDHO called you, and what did they say? How did you sort of, you know, answer them? So then that way you can help other people see that it's not the end of the world, right? Okay, you guys, well, thank you so much for listening, and I hope you're not too concerned. If the CDHO calls you, it will be okay.